Students, the experiment is isolation of DNA from onion. As I told that onion is one of the source which you can extract the DNA very easily. Other than onion also you can try with coconut endosperm as well as from the liver. You can isolate it. There are more steps to be added up when compared to the onion. The experiment is to isolate the DNA from onion. What is the basic principle in isolation of the DNA from onion? A filtrate which is made out of onion is going to be treated with the salt, that is sodium chloride, distilled water and the detergent. The detergent what we are using for the experiment is SDS, that is sodium dodecyl sulfate. Onion is used because it has low starch content which allows the DNA to become clearly visible when you are isolating it. The salt, that is sodium chloride, what you are adding will shield the negatively charged phosphate groups which are present on the DNA and allow the ends of these phosphate groups of DNA to come closer so that they can be precipitated out of the cold alcohol solution. The detergent SDS sodium dodecyl sulfate will cause the cell membrane to break down and emulsify the lipids and the proteins of the cell membrane together. The detergent then forms a complex with the lipids and causes them to precipitate out of the solution. Collectively, the salt solution and the detergent are referred to as the lyse. Now, in the buffer, we are also adding some EDTA. It is a chelating agent and it will remove the divalent atom. Removal of these ions make nuclear and cellular membrane weak and it also will inhibit the digestion of DNA by DNA's enzyme. The detergent, it increases the ionic concentration of DNA mixture and disrupts the ionic bonds between DNA and protein. Concentrated sodium chloride decreases solubility of DNA in ethanol, thereby allowing it to precipitate. Finally, for precipitation, using 95% ethanol, it is used to precipitate the DNA and remove it from the aqueous phase of solution. The salted DNA, you have added in this first stage some salt, sodium chloride. So the salted DNA is making it insoluble in 95% ethanol, and this DNA can be removed by spooling. Now, what are the reagents? First is extraction buffer, which is prepared with 0.1 molar EDTA containing 0.9% weight by volume of MACL. So, to prepare the buffer, we have to weigh 11.6 grams of EDTA and 3 grams of sodium chloride, and we have to dissolve it in about 200 ml of distilled water. Then we have to adjust the pH to 7 using 0.1 normal HCl or 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide. Then we have to make up the final volume to 300 ml with distilled water. Next reagent is 10% SDS. To prepare 50 ml of 10% SDS, weigh 5 gram of SDS and dissolve in 50 ml of the distilled water, and you can prepare 95% of the ethanol. So the skin of the onion was peeled off and chopped into small pieces. The chopped onion pieces were homogenized in a blender for a few seconds or on a low speed mortar to give a fine suspension. For this homogenization, we can use 50 ml of the extraction buffer. The homogenized suspension thus obtained was filtered through 4 layers of cheesecloth. 10 ml of the filtrate was pipetted out into a beaker or into a petri dish or into a test tube. And to this, 1 ml of 10% SDS was immediately added, followed by the addition of ice cold ethanol, and it must be done very slowly by running down the ethanol along the sides of the beaker or the petri dish or test tube where you have taken the onion extract, and it can be left aside for 5 minutes for at room temperature. First thing is observation. Soon after addition of ice cold ethanol, bubble will be formed. You can see the bubble formation, and then that will be followed by DNA precipitation out of the solution and becomes visible as white color strands. The obtained DNA strands was collected in an Eppendorf tube from the solution with a pipette. Confirmation: a small amount of DNA was placed on a slide to which few drops of methylene in the solution was added. You can place a cover slip over the specimen and the slide was observed under a microscope. The result, DNA was isolated from onion as white strands, and its purity can be determined by taking the absorbance at 260 and then absorbance at 280, calculating the ratio spectroscopically. Then the ratio of absorbance at 260 and 280 nanometer provides a rough idea about the extent of contaminants that are present in the preparation. A ratio of 1.8 and 2 is indicative of purely DNA and RNA preparation, but any value less than 1.8 signifies the presence of proteins or phenols as the impurity. Hello students, today the experiment is isolation of DNA from onion. Why did we choose onion? Is because it is having very less content of the starch. So that is why we have chosen onion as a source to isolate the DNA. Then the reagents what we require for the experiment is lysine buffer, which is prepared with EDT and sodium chloride. EDT is a metal chelating agent, so any of the metal ions like sodium or calcium, if is there during the process of extraction, the metal chelating agent like EDT will chelate all those divalent ions, and that will allow the precipitation of DNA. Simultaneously, it will prevent the action of nucleases during the process of extraction. The second compound present in the lysine buffer is sodium chloride, which is a salt. It will shield the phosphate groups which are contributing the negative charges on the DNA. So because of that shielding of the phosphate groups with the sodium ions, it will allow the precipitation of the DNA molecule. Then the next component what we require for the extraction is SDS, which is going to be the sodium dodecyl sulfate, which is a detergent. Now detergent is acting as an emulsifying agent, so the cell membranes containing the lipids and the proteins will undergo emulsification, and it will allow the precipitation of the DNA molecule. Now what we have done is that we have taken the onion. For example, if you are taking one full onion of medium size, you can go with 50 ml of the lysine buffer. But today for the extraction, I have taken only half of the onion. So I have taken only 25 ml of the buffer. So what you are supposed to do is that after taking the onion, peel the skin and cut it into small pieces. You can dice it properly, and after dicing it, you can take it in the mechanical blender, that is a mixie, or even you can use a mortar and pestle. While you are grinding it, the measured volume of your 25 ml or 50 ml what we have taken the lysine buffer can be added little by little in order to grind the onion to get the extract. So what we have got is the extract of the onion where you have used the lysine buffer. Now what we are supposed to do is that we are supposed to filter it. So for filtering, I have placed the funnel which is going to have a muslin cloth. So the extract whatever we have got the onion after grinding, I am going to filter it. So I am just pouring it. So as you know, it is containing some leftover material. So that's why I did not use all the 25 ml of the buffer. So I transferred the remaining material of the extracted onion. So that filtrate, you can see the filtrate. So now what we can do is that we can take some amount of the filtrate. We can take it in a test tube, or you can check it out even by using the petri plate. So in all ways we will try to see. So this is the petri dish. So I will add some amount of the extract into it. See that there are no any air bubbles. So I have taken the onion extract. I have kept in ice. The same thing, you can also take little bit of the extract even in your test tube also. You can check it out in both the ways. So, but before going to the next step, let us add some amount of the SDS. So I have minimum 0.5 to 1 ml you can add. So I am adding the detergent SDS. Okay, so now we should add the ethanol. So ice cold ethanol only has to be added. So I have kept it in ice. So just along the sides, very slowly you can add the ethanol. So when you are adding the ethanol, first there will be some air bubbles developing, and once you get the air bubbles, you will be able to see white color strands. I am already able to observe it, they have come out very well.
And I am adding a little bit more amount. You can see white color strands. You can see it. There is some white color strands. Are you all able to see it? So students, you can observe it. I am rotating it in all directions. You can see it. There are some white color strands. They are all the DNA fibers, the strands which have come out very well. They are all floating on the surface. Now what is this? See here, this is the aqueous layer of the extract. You have added the SDS and then the ethanol. So what has happened from the aqueous extract, the DNA has been extracted and precipitated and it has got accumulated on the ethanol layer, that is an organic solvent. Because DNA, once it binds with the salt, it is insoluble in the organic solvent. So it is able to precipitate and you are able to see the white color strands on the organic ethanol layer. Okay? So let us put it aside. Now, to this one, let us see whether it is, we can see that one even by using this step. So I am adding SDS. Since I have taken in the watch glass, I am adding little bit more amount of the SDS. Now we will add the ethanol. Just from one end I will add. Let us see whether there is any precipitation of the DNA. So keenly observe, there must be formation of air bubbles and the fragments will be, you can see the fragments have started to come out. I will show you in a different background. So I am just adding. It will take some 5 minutes of time because there is lot amount of the sample. So I kept it nice. So I am transferring it into another place. You can see this. You can see here. Here you can see. So it will take some time. Because the volume of the sample what we have taken is more. So it will take. You see now the precipitation is coming out. You can see now. You can see. Add some more. So you can see the white color strands. You can see. You can see now. You can see here. You can see this region. You can see the strands. You can see it. You can see now. All the DNA is precipitated and it is pooling up now too. On top of the and coming to the ethanol layer. You can observe students, you can see here. You can see students, you can see the fragments here, you can see here the strand, you can see somewhere here, you can see, see air bubbles will develop and that will precipitate the DNA out. I will add some more ethanol. Just after 5 minutes you observe, you can find the layer which has been completed will be precipitated with the DNA. You can see here, I am showing you, here you see. You can see, you see, it's breaking off, you see. These are all the white color fragments what you have got, the DNA. You can see, and they are pulling it together. You can pull these DNA students, you can see here. Very nice, it has come out, the DNA. So you can pull all these DNA. Okay, then what you can do, you can check the purity of your DNA sample. So you see, you can see here, this is all the DNA fragments, you can see. Okay, so that is the experiment, isolation of DNA from onion. So when you add the lysing buffer and SDS, you can pull up all these pieces, they are all, see, pieces of DNA. You can take them, you can take it in your Eppendorf tube, and then you can also detect the purity. You can determine the concentration. How to check the purity? Take the absorbance at 260 nanometer and 280 nanometer. So if you find the ratio, depending on the ratio what you are getting, you can determine its purity. Second thing, you can cool it up, dissolve it in saline citrate buffer, and then you can determine the concentration of the DNA. Okay, students, so thank you all for watching it. Thank you, students.